Hey, it's old Uncle Mark from the mothership. We are right here. It is snowing like crazy outside. Not as much snow as maybe you have, but we got quite a bit up here. We got feet on the ground. So this is a classic rock and roll tune, Classic Cream, Classic Clapton, Jack Bruce, Ginger Baker, okay? So this is one of the most badass songs. It's perfect for cigar box guitar, so I'm gonna run through it one time. Sunshine of Your Love, man. This is one of the best songs for cigar box guitar I've found yet. I've just discovered this today, actually. So, the original key for Cream is D. This is D. This song is perfect for the cigar box guitar. Absolutely perfect in every way. So, you know G, G sharp, A, B flat, B. C, you're gonna need a C. C sharp D, you're gonna need a D. D sharp E, F, F sharp G, G sharp A, and it just keeps going and going and going like a big circle, and it just keeps going to infinity. So this song is in D, 1/2 3rd dot, okay? Or 7th fret, so you can just count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, right? So you just count in there and kind of remember where it's at. I see that little dot, and that dot right there lets me know where my D and my C are. So instead of doing this, and back and forth and back and forth, what I want you to start doing is take your 3rd finger on the D, and then go to the 1st finger. Back and forth. So practice going back and forth. It's going to be important. Okay, so remember we talked about ladders. I consider a cigar box guitar neck like a ladder. This is up towards the pickup. This is down towards the nut. So you're walking up the ladder this way or down the ladder. So just kind of turn it and think, oh, I'm walking up the ladder going that way, and I'm going down the ladder going this way, all right? So, we're going to walk down the ladder, individually notes on the D string. See this D string right here? That middle string. We're going to be on the 7th fret. That's an A note. So we're going to walk the A note down with 3rd finger, 2nd finger first. All right? Play an open D, and then we're going to take our hand, move it here, and catch this note right here. It's an F, and see how I use my wrist. I don't use my finger to wiggle notes, right? It's called vibrato, but it's really wiggling. I remember when I first learned vibrato, God, it was probably 25 years ago. It took me an entire summer to get the idea behind vibrato, right? So it's going to take you some time. That's fine. If all you do is, it works perfect, right? You don't. So. Down, twice, so, all down. My pick is all going down. The next set of chords you need to know is the G and the F. And with this song, I want you to use these 2nd inversions. So I want you to have your second finger or your third, okay, on that D note. And I also want the third finger or your pinky, right, on this D note. And then I want your first finger, okay, here on the G. And I want you to play it either this way or this way. It depends on if you're using a slide, right? I mean, we've talked about this with using slides. This is a little homemade slide I made out of a bottle. If you put your slide here, you're gonna have to use these three fingers. If you put your slide here, you're gonna use these two. If you do like Billy Gibbons, and you got one of these little guys on your second finger, you don't have to worry about it so much, but you don't have your second finger. So either way, you're gonna use some of these fingers here. So I tend to do these. I also switch. It's a good idea to be able to do both. So here's your shape. That's the G you're gonna use. You're gonna slide down to this F. So you're gonna slide a whole step or two frets or a whole tone. Whole tone, semitone, these are big $5 words, just meaning moving up and down frets, okay? So get used to do this. A lot of people get it right here and then kind of mess up the shape, right? You kind of don't get the shape right. So you want to practice getting this shape. You should actually practice it up and down the neck. Something to do while you're watching basketball. We got March Madness is coming up right around the corner. You're going to have plenty of time to be watching basketball and playing your cigar box guitar. So, you know, you got the time, right? So I want you to practice playing these second inversions up and down the neck. So G. Okay, just like you walked down the neck with this A, G sharp, G, D, F, G. You're gonna walk from here. D, C sharp, C, G open, B flat, G open. So practice both of these. Start this thing, this process really slow. Song, spice it up a little bit. You know that this note is a D open, and this note is a B flat, or I mean an F, I'm sorry. So it's a D and an F. You also have a D here, and you also have an F here. Because I know that dot, you know, one above the dot, it's an F. Now look at how my wrist moves, right? I don't bend it with my finger like this, right? I'm not bending it with my finger. I'm using my wrist and my elbow. Right? I just remember, right? All I have to do is hop to this string and come up, or hop to this string and come up. I'm kind of looking at it in the video kind of backwards, so. Hop from there to there. And if you can't wiggle it, just hit it. Open A, C, open A. Learned a little bit about vibrato here. So what I'm doing is kind of wiggling this way. Right? You see the whole giddy move, right? That's something to work on. Great song. Easy to play for you guys. I know you can do it. Make sure you work on these inversions. Right? This finger, and this one. Back to F, G, F, G. Makes it a lot easier. You don't have to move around the neck so much. You're right here. If you're playing live and giddy's way down there and you're playing and you're having it down here, it's easy to work it rather than moving all around the neck. So old Uncle Mark with another lesson. Cream, Sunshine of Your Love, Jack Bruce, Ginger Baker, Eric. You know, what can I say? It's iconic tune, wonderful song. I have a virtual tip jar down below in the show notes. It's paypal.me/UncleMarkTips. I thank you so much for every donation you give me. Also, thanks for the subscriptions. It really helps. Sharing on Facebook. All of these things help. Any social media sharing helps me out. I appreciate it, and we'll see you next time.